Lens. The word reminds us of the lens in our camera or the lens in a spectacle or even the lens in the pinhole of our main door. Hello friends, today we will play around with concave and convex lenses. We have been learning that a concave lens is a diverging lens and a convex lens is a converging lens. So today we will carry out this experiment to see if that's the reality. All that you would need to perform this experiment are a transparent box, preferably a big one. If you want, you can use any box which is transparent. For example, you can make use of the vegetable box inside the refrigerator if it is transparent. You would need two laser lights, a convex lens and a concave lens along with the lens stand which we had made before, some water, Dettol solution and talcum powder. So to start the experiment, we take this container and put some water into the container. Now we add few drops of Dettol solution. If you want, you can also add any soap solution or detergent solution. Mix it properly so that the Dettol solution mixes completely with the water. So now what we do, we take the convex lens and put it in the lens holder. So just to remind you, which one is a convex lens? The one which has tapered ends, that is thinner ends and thick in between. So that's our convex lens. So put this lens on inside this container. So now we have our setup ready. So let us first try to understand the concept behind what we are going to do. So this is our convex lens, thicker in between and thinner at the ends. Now you can consider this lens as a series of small refracting prisms, as you can see here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 prisms together make this lens. Now what happens when light enters these prisms? So whenever a light enters this prism, there is a change in medium. So light enters from rarer medium, that is air, to denser medium, that is glass. So due to this change in medium, what happens? The velocity of the light changes. As a result, the light bends. Now the bending is different in each of these pieces of prisms. Why is that? That's because we have changed the shape of the prisms, right? So the shape of these surfaces of the prisms are changed. Therefore, the angle at which the ray is incident on each of these prisms is also changed. So as a result, different rays coming out of each of these pieces, they bend differently and they meet at one point. So here you see point P, where all the rays of light meet. And that is the reason we call a convex lens a converging lens, because the rays converge at a point after refraction. So now we will experimentally see this phenomenon. So for that we need some incident ray of light. And for that we will make use of the laser light. Now you switch off the light to get a better view of the rays of laser light. Take both the lasers and focus them from one end of the box. So now you can see two different beams. Now what do you see? The two rays after refraction, what happens? They seem to converge at a point. Correct? So we see here that the convex lens indeed behaves like a converging lens. So did you get that? Why did we put the soap solution? So that these laser light become distinctly visible. Because if we had not put the soap solution, then the tiny molecules would have been not able to scatter the laser light and it would have not been visible. So let us now do the same thing for a concave lens. So let us take out the convex lens and now we'll put the concave lens. So the concave lens is thinner in between and it is thicker at the edges. So we put it inside. So just like the convex lens, in case of concave lens, since the shape here is different, the concept still remains the same. So here also you have various pieces of refracting prisms, and now in this case the way light gets bent after refraction is little different. That is because of this shape of the lens. Now, when the shape is altered, the angle at which the ray encounters or the ray falls on the lens, that also gets altered. So, as a result, in this case, we see after refraction, all the rays, they tend to move away from each other. That is, they diverge. So, it seems as if we extrapolate them backwards, they seem to be coming from this point P, but they actually do not meet at point P. They just seem to be coming from point P. So that is why this type of lens is called a diverging lens, because the rays diverge after refraction. So again, we will see this experimentally. So switch off the light and project the laser on the lens. So here you see the rays after refraction, they seem to be moving away from each other, right? So very clearly you can see that the distance between the two rays are increasing as they are going forward. So this proves that a concave lens behaves as a diverging lens. In case you do not have the box which I had used, you can make use of the refrigerator vegetable box. So you see in this box also, for convex lens, we very clearly see that they converge at a point after refraction. Similarly, for concave lens, you can see that the rays diverge after refraction. So I think this vegetable box is very easily available at your home, so you can perform this experiment using that. So let us now try to perform the same experiment in air. So we just remove the container with water and we place the lens in the holder and put it here. Now we project the laser light on the lens. But what happens? We are not able to see the rays. So for that, what we do, so the same concept, there we used soap solution and here we will use talcum powder. So just blow the talcum powder and you will be able to see the rays. So here you see that the rays are converging because this is a convex lens. So let us now try to repeat the same thing with concave lens and we will see now the rays would diverge. So this will become visible the moment we blow the talcum powder. I hope you enjoyed it. All you need to do now is try this experiment yourself in your own innovative ways. And do not forget to share a picture of your experiment to examfearvideos@gmail.com. We would love to share it on our Facebook page. Last but not the least, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We keep uploading many such interesting informative videos every day. Thank you so much.